Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to continue working on part 5 of this house build. Let's get started. So in the last video, we were able to add closet and then we added some curtain wall windows. And as you can see, we're not yet finished with the below and also at the back. So now we're going to continue working on this. So let's go to level 1 and add some curtain wall. So here I'm in level 1. I'm going to click wall. And you just need to navigate to curtain wall. And then after that, we could just add the curtain wall from the wall. So here I'm going to do this all the way there. And we're gonna add curtain wall on this side as well. So here I'm gonna do click wall again, and I'm going to add curtain wall all the way here. And then here I'm gonna add as well. And then here I'm gonna add a small one. And I'm going to add the one at the side as well. So here I'm going to click wall again. And I'm going to add it here on this side. And then after that, click modify and then cut geometry. You click the wall first and then the curtain wall. So wall and then curtain wall. Wall and curtain wall. After that, go to 3D. We need to pull them down like so, and then pull up like this. And we're gonna fix that later on here as well. Pull it down and pull it up. And what we could do is we could set up the height for this, so like that, and then I'm going to align this, and then align this as well, but I'm gonna put it all the way down. This one I'm gonna copy, and let's copy the height of this for the front and the height for the lower. Here I'm gonna just copy the one at the top, so align this, and then this one I will pull it up just like that. I just want it to be small enough, like so. Okay, so now we could design this. So I'm gonna design it by adding curtain grid. So here I'm gonna design it like this. So probably around 500 at the top. And then click curtain again, curtain grid, and then 500 as well here. So for now it's 400, this one's 500, and I'm gonna align them all together. This one's 500 and this one's 500, so I'm just copying it like that. And then we need curtain grid again to make this like so. This one I'm just gonna make it from the bottom, and then this one all segmented again, I'm going to go to south elevation. I don't like the size of the wall of the window, so I'm gonna make it shorter a little bit, like that. So 4,000, that's enough. And then I'm gonna get the curtain grid and divide them, so it's exactly 1,000 each. After that, I'm gonna click mullion. I'm gonna go 3D, and I'm gonna make sure that I'm selecting all grid, and not the 150. I want it to be 50 by 65. I think that's enough. And then now we need to click on all curtain grid so that we have our mullion. I will need to maybe delete one of those. Okay, I forgot here. I'm gonna fix that. I forgot to put some grid lines. And I'm gonna fix this. So I'm going to add grid. And probably the grid will be 500 at the top. Okay. And then here as well, 500 at the top. And then I'm just gonna add one segment, 500 here, 500 there. So this one, this kind of design looks better. Maybe I could use that on all. So this one, I'm just gonna add like that. Let me see if I already added. Okay, I added the window there. So that kind of design, I kind of like it to be added here. So maybe I could delete all the mullion first. So I'm deleting not the mullion but the grid line. Actually, I'm just gonna delete the one in the middle. And there we go. Same look. Okay, so that's done. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add floor. So I'm gonna add floor for level one. So here I'm going to go to architecture and click floor. I'm going to edit this type, duplicate floor number one, edit type. Thickness around 200 is enough. And then here we could go to stone or flooring. I'll do stone, so I'm gonna use peeled stone. Press OK and then OK and then OK. I'm going to add this one, so I'm gonna use pick line and then all the perimeter, but except for the parking. We're just going to go around that parking. So I'm gonna type in TR, trim and extend, And once it's done, click finish. So the flooring for that is done. And then next, let's go second floor, level 2. We're gonna add the flooring, but from the inner side. So here, I'm gonna edit type, duplicate. This will be floor number 2. Edit type, change the materials. I like mixing different floors. So here, I'm gonna go stone again. But maybe I'm gonna add wood. So I'm gonna use marble for now. Apply and then okay, and then okay. Now let's add in. So let's go back to level 1. I wanna make sure that I didn't change this. So see, I was able to change it with level 2, but now level 2, and then now I'm gonna press escape and click roof floor again. I want to make sure that I'm selecting level 2, so sorry for the confusion. And then after that, I'm gonna pick line, and then I'm going to the inner of the wall. Oh, not that one. I'm gonna undo that. So all inner. And then here, I'm gonna use TR, trim and extend, to extend that. As you know, we have our balcony here. And then here, we just need to type in TR to clean this up. And I want to make sure everything is done. And click finish. Don't attach. And then let's look at it at 3D. Okay. As you can see, we need to pull this down. So that's done for that one. And this side as well. AL. This part will be harder because we need to pull this down. So this wall is, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add in some fillers, or I'm gonna show you so it's easier for us not to pull anything down. For this spot, it's okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to create an extrusion or a sweep. Sweep, I believe sweep is enough. So let's do it again. Model in place. I'm gonna sweep, pick path. I'm gonna use 3D for this, and I want to make sure that I use TR to trim and extend this, but I'm going to pull this out. So technique is click this and then TR this so that you know that it's only up to there. Okay, so now I'm gonna delete this now, so it's only up to there. But here we need to pull this out manually. Up to here only. I think that's good enough. And then here we just need to add. So we're done with picking that path. And then now edit profile. After that, you can see that we could fill this up. So just, we can even create a design. We could extend this a little. Okay, so we'll make this 300. And let's see. Click finish, and as you can see, it kind of created this this design, so it looks good. I'm gonna set the materials. So here I'm gonna change this to probably parking stripe for now, because I don't know what kind of color I'm gonna put this one in. And I kind of like it, so maybe I could do it at the top as well. So it looks good the way it looks. Okay. And then let's add in the roof for this. And of course, we're going to use a flat roof. I'm going to click roof. It will set to level 2. And then I'm going to edit this type, duplicate. This will be our roof 1. Press OK, edit type. This will be white. We're gonna choose the same one, gypsum wallboard 200 thickness. Press OK, and then now let's go to level 2. That's supposed to be level 3. Okay. We're going to pick line. It will be the inside. And I want to make sure that define slope is turned off. So I'm going to undo this first. And then uncheck this. And then now we could do it again. Okay, so now let's use TR to clean this border. And I want to make sure that everything is connected and trimmed. So now click finish. And then base offset is minus 200 so that it's flat. Look at it in 3D. And then what you have to do is select this one individually. Use control so that you can select multiple. So once we select everything, similar to what I'm doing right now, click this and click the roof. And it will disappear. This one again. Oh no, not this one. Click this and then click the roof. So that's faster than clicking it individually and putting negative 200. So at least that's easy now. So I'm planning to just extend this wall upwards so that to just show a difference in height. So I'm just looking at how am I gonna do this. So maybe this one will be best to pull up a little. So I'm just looking at my perspective. So basically I just wanted to have a difference in height so that it doesn't look flat. But it's just for design purpose. So that this will work. I would like this one, so AL. And we could just even put an extrusion here so that it's like squared. And here we could actually extend this one as well, the sweep. So it looks good. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paint this lower. I would like this lower to be white, so I'm going to paint this face, so click paint, and gypsum wallboard, so that will be white there. And also for this face, I'm gonna change this. So this one will be a different, maybe a stone for this. I would like this one to be stone. Maybe this one will be a different color. Or I will put it here. I'm still gonna put something here, like a design, maybe. And then maybe I could change this as well. So now I'm going to create an extrusion for the back of this. Oops. So another generic model. Extrusion. And then for materials, let's figure that out later on. I'm gonna set this, so pick a plane. I'm going to select this as my plane and click this rectangle like so. After that, click finish. As you can see, it's extruded. And then I'm going to change this, so maybe another stone. I'll use slate for now, and then click finish, and then I'm going to align this on all. So now I would like this face to be slate as well, so I'm going to go and look for slate. Okay, so I'm gonna select this and paint this. I'm gonna paint this, I'm gonna paint this, and the top faces of this and I'm going to do this as well. Because if I click this, it will be showing here. So I'm thinking, what should I do with this? I will look into it once we send it to Twinmotion, so that I can see. I want to see if it's showing. But for now, this is good enough. I'm gonna leave this one like this. I'm thinking if I should extend it more, but this one will look good enough. I could go to south elevation so that I could set this design. I'm thinking another model in place, a square or a C. So generic model, and then extrusion, pick a plane. I'm gonna select this plane, and let's do it white first. So gypsum warm board, okay, and then now let's design this. Or I could just do this, it's easier for me. And then click it again, offset of 100. Click spacebar so that it's inside. And then click finish, and I wanna see it. Click finish again, and we could just manually extrude it. So it looks like this. I would like to put it all the way here. And maybe we could change this face. So I'm gonna go back to hidden line, and I'm gonna click split face, and I want to split face this face. So I want to do this. So now, this is split now. As you can see, I could select this. You can now change this material. So here, let's look for something that we haven't selected yet. So I'm gonna choose, I think brick, I haven't used it. So I'm gonna use brick for now. And then go back. And as you can see, it's a different finish because it has some hatching. So we're gonna stop here for now and continue on the next video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you liked the video. Please hit like and subscribe. Feel free to comment down below.